Hello, everyone, all who are in one body of Christ. Our Savior welcomes you to the Lord has given us together. Today, we'll be meditating upon, are you questioning his mercy? Before we start, let's see what Scripture talks about in this topic. Romans chapter 8, verse 38 through 39. And I am convinced that nothing can ever separate us from God's love, neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons. Neither our fears for today nor our worries about tomorrow. Not even the power of hell can separate us from God's love. No power in the sky above or in the below earth. Indeed, nothing in all creation will be ever able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus our Lord. Now let's see what we can learn from the verse we have just read. Most asked questions is how can we say that God is merciful and just when there is a lot of trouble for our world. Rather than wondering why someone will spend eternity in hell, we ought to wonder in grateful amazement why he chooses to rescue any of us. Have we really been good enough to earn his highest rewards? Have we been so devoted to his ideals that he should welcome us with open arms? Though famine, war, battered wives, and children's hospital wings will always be hard to square and swallow. What we are seeing is the result of life in a fallen world, where human sin has done to our mortal condition. The fall of mankind, the curse of sin that each of us is born with, is based on the original sin of Adam, which has given us evil, decay, and sadness, a period of time to operate on earth until they are removed eternally for God's people at the end of the days. Yet even now, even though we have brought so much on ourselves, the Bible teaches us that in all our distress, he too is distressed. Though we might struggle mightily, he is carrying us through it. He loves us that much. He gave us the life, and even we are destined and deserve eternal punishment and misery. He has planned our salvation and everlasting life with him. We must trust him with all our hearts and mind to receive his graceful mercies for every single moment of our lives we have on this planet and the life we received after when we complete our journey and return back to him. This message also gives us a promise for our day today. The promise is, for this is how God loved the world. He gave his one and only Son, that everyone who believes in him will not perish but have eternal life. God sent his Son into the world not to judge the world, but to save the world through him. Let's close this time in prayer together. Please join me in this prayer. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, mighty wonderful God, thank you for the breath of life you have given me today. Lord, I thank you for giving me another chance, another day to live this life, to show your glory, your mercies all around me. Help me to understand your plan for my existence and use me today for the purpose you have brought me here. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Have a blessed day, everyone, and if God's willing, we will talk to you tomorrow.